assisted AETG elevated lunge. Now, you can use a stick to hold on for support. Otherwise, you can also set up your elevation next to a wall or something similar to make it easier. The idea is of this movement, you really want to focus on range of motion. That is really the key thing we're trying to work on with this exercise. Now, when it comes to the elevation, higher the elevation, the easier it'll be. If you go too high, so anything sort of past lower shin level is just going to be too excessive. So here I'm just using a 10 kilo plate. You can use something similar, or again, a little bit higher is fine. The key thing to focus on, the key thing to keep in mind with this though is, this is a rubber coated weight on rubber flooring. It's not going to slide anywhere. There's a lot of friction. So just make sure whatever you use, it's safe. So set up for the exercise. If I'm working my right side, then I'm holding the support structure in my left hand. So right leg is up on the elevation. I'm going to come into a pretty long split for my setup. And then the two key things I'm focusing on are one, keeping my back leg straight and getting as far forward as I can with my front knee. So it's going to look like this. I'm going to sink into it nice and deep and push back. One, two, one more, three. Do one side, then do the other. Pretty straightforward. So as you can see, I'm really trying my hardest to get my knee as far forward as I can. If I'm lifting up off my heel a little bit and pushing onto my toes, that's okay. A small amount isn't a big deal. Again, the key thing to focus on is just making sure that you don't use momentum and making sure you're getting as low and as far forward as you can. Some key things to watch out from a technique perspective is if you allow your back leg to bend, then that's going to limit your range of motion, right? So you always want to make sure that your back leg is staying relatively straight. And then another key mistake people will often make is they'll sort of bounce out of the bottom position. You want to sink into it gradually, control that end range position, and then come back out of it. You don't want to rush the movement. Other than that, it's pretty straightforward.